Down came a big black horse. He headed for the butcher's block. Look! As quick as a flash, he stole the meat so that he can have himself a tasty treat.
My meat! He stole my meat!
Oh, he stole the meat! The hawk stole the meat! Hey,
look! The clever hawk zigzagged around and flew all over the eastern town. To make him drop what the butcher owns, the village boys threw many stones. Osada watched all this and thought of a plan that can't miss. He watched, he studied, he eyed. He observed the hawk fly from side to side. Suddenly, in that same direction, Osada made a dash. As quick as lightning, as quick as a flash. In the hawk's shadow, he stopped and stood, clapped sharply and yelled as loud as he could. So piercing was Osada's loud cry, the terrified hawk thought he was going to die. By a sharp arrow he had been struck, in his body it was stuck. Panic stricken, the hawk dropped the meat. Osada caught it, standing on his feet. About the quarreling men and asked them to resolve it there and then.
Why are you quarreling, sirs?
He stole my cows.
These are my cows. What are you talking about?
Okay. Will you accept what I decide?
Yes, sir.
What do you feed your cattle and what do you give them to drink?
Sir, I give them very expensive beans and flour, with a side of rice gruel to devour.
And you, sir?
I cannot afford to feed my cows beans and rice gruel, so I feed them grass, and to drink, I give them water.
So grass and water, and beans and rice gruel. Okay. So let's mix the panic seeds. Now, give these to the cows for them to drink.
He then gave the mixture to all the cows, so inside their bellies, gentle vomit can arouse. The cows threw up only grass from the first to the very last. To judge a case, evidence is key. Who is telling the truth? Everyone could see.
Why would you lie? Can you explain?
Sorry, sir. I did it for gain.
Never steal, never lie.
I promise, Osada, I will try.
O-S-A-D-A, who do we appreciate? Osada!
She wore it a lot. The necklace is the best thing that she's got. One hot day, she needed to take a nice cool bath down at the lake. She placed the necklace on her clothes and went to the water to dip her toes. Whilst bathing, a young woman came by. The beautiful necklace caught her eye. She asked,
"This necklace looks so beautiful. Can I try it for some?"
The young one took it and ran away. The elderly woman hurried out. To the young one, she started to shout.
Hey, that's bad.
No, I have nothing on me that you own. It's my necklace. It's mine.
The two women began to fight. It was not a pretty sight. A big crowd gathered around to watch the women knock each other down.
They're fighting! Osada! Osada, help! Help!
Why are you quarreling?
She's gone. It's got my necklace. It has another
car.
No, it's mine. It's mine.
Mine!
It's mine! Give me that.
Over your case, I will carefully preside. Will you accept what I decide? Okay. Can I have the necklace? Whoa, this necklace smells very nice. What perfume do you use?
I use the most expensive perfume of all. It comes from the rose flower, from what I
know. Okay. And what perfume do you use? So you use the pingu and you use the rose flower. Okay. Can someone bring a perfume smeller?
Here, perfume smeller. Come, perfume seller.
With this bowl full of water, I'll put the necklace in. Can you tell me what flower you smell?
Ah, the smell is sweet. The smell is deep. I think it might come from the pingu flower.
Yes, Osada.
To judge a case, evidence is key. Who is telling the truth, everyone could see.
Why do you lie? Can you explain?
I'm sorry. I did it for gain.
Never steal, never lie.
Never steal, never lie.